Hello everyone, welcome to the series PIB analysis. I'm your mentor Manish Mishra and in this session we'll discuss PIB news through 5 MCQs. This series will be beneficial for various government exams like RBI, UPSC and state PSC exams. Okay, so let's begin with the session guys. And first question is, to preserve and promote various forms of folk art and culture of the tribals throughout the country, Ministry of Culture has set up zonal cultural centers. What is are not true about the ZCCs and the schemes implemented by these zonal cultural centers? So we have to identify the incorrect statement about zonal cultural centers and the schemes implemented by them. Okay, so these zonal cultural centers was set up to promote the cultural heritage of various regions. Okay, and there are 7 zonal cultural centers in India, which are northern, eastern, western, southern, south central, north central and northeastern. So there are 7 zonal cultural centers in India, and these were set up to promote cultural heritage of these regions. Okay, so let us first have a glimpse of news. So there are various schemes which are being implemented by ZCCs. Number one is young talented artist, under which talented youngsters of age group 18 to 30 are selected and given a one-time cash award of ₹10,000. Next is Guru Shishya Parampara, jiske andar Gurukul tradition ke according training programs carry out kiye jaate hain. Next is theatre rejuvenation, which is to promote theatre activities, and under this honorarium up to 30,000 per show is paid. Next is research and documentation. After that, Shilpgram, under which seminar and workshop and exhibitions are being organized for the artisans living in rural areas. And next is Octave, which is to promote and propagate the cultural heritage of Northeast region to the rest of India. Okay, Northeast region ke cultural heritage ko promote karne ke liye aur pure India mein propagate karne ke liye Octave scheme chalai gayi hai. And next is National Cultural Exchange Program, under which various festivals like yatras, exhibition, arts, seminars, workshops are organized in member states of the various zonal cultural centers. Now let's come to the questions. So option number one, we have to identify the incorrect statement. Okay, and the option number one is there are 8 zonal cultural centers. No, there are 7, which are northern, eastern, western, southern, south central, north central and northeastern. Okay, so this option is incorrect. Now next is Octave is a scheme to develop northeastern cultural heritage. Yes, this is absolutely correct. Next is to promote theatre activities, honorarium up to 50,000 per show is paid. No, this honorarium is up to ₹30,000. And next is, so this option is incorrect. ₹10,000 is given under the scheme young talented artist to the talented youngsters. Yes, this is also correct. So we have to identify incorrect. Therefore, option number B, 1 and 3 must be the right answer. Okay. Ministry of Culture has launched a scheme of scholarship and fellowship for promotion of art and culture. And we have to identify the incorrect statement regarding the amount provided under the 3 components of the scheme. This scheme was launched to give assistance to young artists. So let us discuss which are the 3 components of the scheme. So component number 1 is award of scholarship to young artists in different cultural fields, jisme up to 400 scholarship di jayengi in the age group 18 to 25, and the amount is ₹5,000 per month. Okay. Next is award of senior or junior fellowships to outstanding persons in the fields of agriculture. Isme 2 category hai, senior or junior. Junior ke liye age group hai 25 to 40, and for senior it is above 40. For junior category, the scholarship is ₹10,000 per month, and for senior categories, it is ₹20,000 per month. Next is Tagore National Fellowship for Cultural Research. Isme koi age limit nahi hai, aur isme fellows ko 80,000 per month, and to scholars, ₹50,000 per month is given. Okay, so now let's come to the question. So option A is Rs 5000 per month under award of scholarships to young artists in different cultural fields component. Yes, this is absolutely correct. Next, Rs 10,000 per month under award of senior or junior fellowships to outstanding persons in the fields of culture component to the fellows between age group of 25 to 40. Yes, in the junior fellowship in the age group of 25 to 40, Rs 10,000 is provided. Next, Rs 20,000 per month under award of senior or junior fellowships to outstanding persons in the fields of culture component to the fellows of age above 40 years. Yes, this is also correct. It is senior fellowship. This is absolutely correct. Now, under Tagore National Fellowship for Cultural Research Component, fellows are provided 80,000 per month. Yes, this is also correct. And under Tagore National Fellowship for Cultural Research Component, scholars are provided Rs 1 lakh. No, the scholars are provided Rs 50,000, which means this option is incorrect. And we have to identify the incorrect statement. Therefore, option E must be the right answer. I hope this question is clear now. Next is, under the Energy Conservation Act 2001, Ministry of Power has launched the star labeling program for deep freezer and light commercial air conditioners. Okay, find the correct statement about the mode, voluntary or mandatory, of the program. Okay, so ye jo star labeling program hai, it was launched on the foundation day of Bureau of Energy Efficiency, in short BEE, which was on 2nd March. Okay, so on 2nd March, Ministry of Power has launched this star labeling program for deep freezer and light commercial air conditioners on the foundation day of Bureau of Energy Efficiency. Okay, and we have to find the correct statement about the mode, voluntary or mandatory. This program is launched so that we can save units of energy. Units of energy ko save karne ke liye ye program launch kiya gaya, and ye units of energy save karke hum millions of tons carbon dioxide ko bhi save kar payenge, jisse greenhouse gas jo hai wo hamari reduce ho jayegi. Greenhouse gas ka jo emission hai wo hamara reduce ho jayega. Okay, so this scheme was launched to reduce the consumption of units of energy so that we can reduce the emission of greenhouse gases. Okay, and there is a target, and we can save up to 9 billion units of energy by 2030 by this program. Okay, so let us go to the options. It is mandatory from the beginning. No, it is not mandatory from the beginning. It is voluntary from the beginning. No. Next is, it is voluntary from 2nd March 2020 to 31st December 2021. Yes, it is voluntary up to 31st December 2021 from 2nd March 2020, and after this it will be made mandatory. Iske baad isko mandatory kar diya jayega. Okay, so ye voluntary hai 2nd March 2020 se leke 31st December 2021 tak. Alright, aur is inclusion ke baad jo BEE hai, matlab Bureau of Energy Efficiency, wo ये स्टार लेबलिंग प्रोग्राम 26 अप्लायंसेस के लिए लॉन्च कर देगा, एंड थ्रू दिस प्रोग्राम इट इज एक्सपेक्टेड टू सेव अप्रोक्स 9 बिलियन यूनिट्स ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी बाय 2030, एंड इट वाज लॉन्च्ड ऑन 19th फाउंडेशन डे ऑफ ब्यूरो ऑफ एनर्जी एफिशिएंसी, व्हिच वाज ऑन 2nd मार्च बाय द मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ पावर. आई होप गाइस दिस क्वेश्चन इज क्लियर नाउ. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, व्हाट इज द पर्पस ऑफ उदित इनिशिएटिव लॉन्च्ड बाय मिनिस्ट्री ऑफ पावर. दिस उदित इनिशिएटिव वाज लॉन्च्ड विद द स्टार लेबलिंग प्रोग्राम, जो कि हमने अभी पिछले क्वेश्चन में पढ़ा था. एंड स्टार लेबलिंग प्रोग्राम कब लॉन्च हुआ था? ऑन द फाउंडेशन डे ऑफ ब्यूरो ऑफ एनर्जी एफिशिएंसी, व्हिच वाज ऑन 2nd मार्च. सो ये इनिशिएटिव उदित उसी के साथ लॉन्च हुआ था, एंड उदित का एक फुल फॉर्म भी है, ऊर्जा दक्षता इंफॉर्मेशन टूल इज द फुल फॉर्म ऑफ उदित. ओके, and this tool was launched to facilitate a database on energy efficiency. Energy efficiency ke liye ek database taiyar karne ke liye Udit initiative, which stands for Urja Dakshata Information Tool, was launched on 2nd March, which was the foundation day of Bureau of Energy Efficiency. Okay, so yahan pe sab kuch given hai, It is Urja Dakshata Information Tool is the full form of UDIT, and it aims to facilitate a database on energy efficiency, and it was launched on 19th Foundation Day of BEE. Okay. So last question for today is the study impact of the Swachh Bharat Mission Grameen on the convenience, safety and self-respect of women in rural India has been done in 5 states, Bihar, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Rajasthan and Uttar Pradesh in February 2020. Who were the co-partners in doing this study? Is study ko kisne milke kiya? Aur study ka naam kya hai? The impact of the Swachh Bharat Mission Grameen on the convenience, safety and self-respect of women in rural India. So the co-partners were, let me tell you answer first, UNICEF and Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation. UNICEF chief is Henrietta Fore and Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, हम सब जानते हैं, Bill Gates और Melinda Gates उनकी वाइफ मिलके चलाते हैं, okay? And UNICEF is headed by Henrietta Fore, okay? Now, इस स्टडी के बारे में थोड़ा सा पढ़ लेते हैं. Approximately 70,000 women का सर्वे किया गया था, जिसके बाद ये रिवील हुआ कि after the increased access to household toilets, there are some improvements in Suvidha, Suraksha and Swabhiman of women in rural India. And kuch data bhi release hua hai, jiske according 93% women feel safer from assault by not going out in the open to defecate. 91% women save up to 1 hour of their day and 88% of women are proud to own a toilet. So we can say Swachh Bharat Mission Grameen एक सक्सेसफुल मिशन है गवर्नमेंट ऑफ इंडिया का, और इसके लिए जो स्टडी हुई है इससे भी हमें पॉजिटिव रिजल्ट्स दिखाई देते हैं. ऑलराइट, आई होप सो दिस क्वेश्चन इज अगेन क्लियर नाउ. सो दिस वाज द लास्ट क्वेश्चन फॉर टुडे गाइस. आई होप यू लाइक दिस सेशन. इफ यू लाइक दिस सेशन प्रेस द लाइक बटन, एंड आगे के सेशंस के अपडेट होने के लिए हमारे चैनल को सब्सक्राइब करिए एंड बेल आइकन को प्रेस करिए. सो आई होप यू लाइक द सेशंस. गुड बाय, टेक केयर. God bless.